Giridhar Jain, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now today I am going to deliver a lecture on auto-ranging circuit for DVM. Now learning outcomes of the session are, at the end of the session, students will be able to draw and design auto-ranging circuit for digital voltmeter. Contents are auto-ranging circuit for DVM, circuit explanation and design considerations. Now auto-ranging circuit for DVM. Now using manual selector switch, you have to change select the appropriate switch depending on the magnitude of input. That is a manual range selector. Now if you want a auto ranging facility for your DVM, now this selection of the switches is to be done automatically by monitoring the input voltage. Okay. Now here in this circuit, the attenuator is provided by connecting the resistances 9 mega ohm, 900K, 90K, 9K and 1K as shown, and the switches are SA, SB, SC, SD and SE. These are the solid state switches. Then output is clamped to 4.7 volt by using the two Zener diodes, and buffer voltage follower is connected at the output, which will avoid the loading effect, and this output of this voltage follower goes to integrator. Now below is the auto ranging control circuit. Now this will consist of the four comparators as shown, and the negative, that is inverting terminal of all these comparator, is connected together, and that is connected to 1K of the attenuator as shown. And the input to the comparators are as shown in the figure. Means after 9 meg, it will go to upper comparator, then after 900K, then lower next comparator, like that. And the output of these four comparators is, let it is VO1, VO2, VO3 and VO4, it will go to 4H16. Decoder. Now 4S16 decoder, output of this 4S16 decoder, okay, is, now here there will be 16 outputs, out of which the 5 are used here, and output of the 4S16 decoders are active low. Now outputs Y0 bar, Y8 bar, Y12, Y14 and Y15 are connected, and these output of these decoders, they will be connected to control switches SE, SD, SC, SB and SA respectively. Means these outputs will control the solid state switches SA, SB, SC, SD and SE. Right? Now in this table you will understand, it will give the auto range selection how it is done. Now whenever input voltage is 0 to 0.2, then output of 4 comparators is high, that is VO1, VO2, VO3 and VO4 is high. Now this circuit connections and the value of resistances are selected such that whenever input is in between 0 to 0.2, VO1, VO2, VO3 and VO4, that is output of all comparators is high, and when output of all comparators is high, then that is Y15 of the decoder will go low, and after inverter it is connected to switch SA, means switch SA is made on in this way. Now whenever input voltage in between 0 to 2 volt, then what happens? The output of comparator 1, 2, 3, that is VO1, VO2 and VO3 are high and VO4 is low. So you can look at the circuit again. Whenever input voltage is between 0 to 2 volt, VO1, VO2, VO3, logic 1 and VO4 is low. And therefore, you can see the Y14 is selected. So here it is 1110, so Y14 will go low and it will control switch SB. Similarly, whenever input voltage is 20 volt, then Y12 is selected, which will control switch SC. Then whenever input voltage is 200 volt, VO1 is 1 and the remaining 3 output are 0. Therefore Y8 is low, right? So switch SD is selected. And whenever input voltage is 2000 volt, output of all the comparators are low and therefore Y0 is selected, and you can see switch SE is selected. So in this way, the circuit works in auto-ranging mode, right? So here important components or elements of the circuit are the range selector switches, which are solid state switches, then 4 comparators and the 4H16 decoder, okay? Now pause this video and think on this question. So shall we measure the small AC voltages using digital voltmeter? Now small AC voltages, now if the voltage measured is greater than 0.7 volt, that can be rectified by using the diode, and you can measure, means you convert AC into the DC by using ordinary rectifiers using diode. But if input voltage is small, less than say 0.7 of the order of say few millivolts, then ordinary diode cannot be used as a rectifier, because it diodes will not conduct, and therefore precision rectifiers are used to convert small AC into the DC, and then DC is given as an input to the DVM. Now this figure shows the precision Fourier rectifier using the op amp. Now first circuit, first op amp will act as an active half wave rectifier, that is a half wave precision rectifier, and the second circuit will act as a adder, right? Now second circuit will act as an adder, which will add the AC input voltage and the output of rectifier, and then the output of adder is a full wave rectified output, and it is filtered by a capacitor CM. Now this output voltage of the second circuit is scaled to RMS value of the input by adjusting gain of the adder, that is by adjusting a potentiometer of 5 kilo ohm as shown in the figure. Okay, so in this way the small AC voltages can be rectified using a full wave precision rectifier as shown in the circuit, and the output of this full wave precision rectifier is scaled to show the RMS value of input by adjusting the gain of the circuit by adjusting the preset or potentiometer of 5K. Now design considerations. Now in this auto ranging circuit, the switches which are used, that is SA to SE, 5 switches are used. So these switches are not mechanical switches, you have to use a solid state switches, and for solid state switches a CMOS switch IC CD4066 can be used. Okay, then second is comparators. Now for the comparators we require a high sensitivity, so high sensitivity comparator MUA710 can be used. Then for the decoder, so we are using 4S16 decoder in the auto ranging circuit. So for the 4S16 decoder, use the decoder IC 74156, which will have the 4 input and 16 outputs, and outputs are active low. So this IC can be used as 4S16 decoder. And op amp which are used are LM324 or LM741, can be used as a operational amplifier for designing this circuit. Okay, so in this way, by using this ICs, you can design the circuit of auto ranging. Now these are the references: op amp and linear integrated circuits by Ramakant Gaikwad, and second is electronic system design by Vaibhav Tarate. Now thank you for watching the video.